I've always been intrigued and fascinated and in love with the natural world. And one of my drives to coming to graduate school is to understand how to improve the relationship between human beings and their environment. My research is looking at a particular group of fungi in Yasuní National Park, which is in the Amazon region of Ecuador. The genus name of the fungi that I'm looking at is Xylaria, and they are the predominant wood decay fungi that we find in this particular region. Some of the major goals I have for this project is to understand the amount of diversity within the genus Xylaria that we see in Yasuní National Park. And so what I'm doing now is I'm going back, sampling fruiting bodies, and I'm extracting DNA and sequencing a particular region within the fungus's genome that we can use as kind of a barcode. If you think of a barcode in a store, it allows you to identify a product. In a similar way, these regions that we're amplifying act in the same way that we can compare them with other sequences that have been deposited in public databases and try to find which ones they match most closely so we can get a better identity based on data that is less subjective than the morphology that has been used to characterize and classify these fungi in the past. One of the reasons I'm drawn to this particular group of fungi in Yasuní National Park is one, it's an incredibly biodiverse location, but two, it's actually under quite a bit of threat. It happens to sit on top of one of Ecuador's largest oil reserves, and there's currently oil being extracted daily. And we don't know what long-term effects this may have, what spills may occur, what resources may be lost. I'm also interested because these fungi produce a lot of secondary metabolites that can be used in pharmaceuticals, medicine, bioenergy production. So there's kind of a timeline on this with the oil extraction that's occurring. We don't know how long we'll have this resource and what impacts it may undergo in the next 10, 20 years.